If you were lucky enough to have George Yonts and Glenn Payne as your musical mentors, chances are good you'll one day be inducted into the Hall of Fame. This was the blessing and great fortune of a young Mark Trammell. As a child, Mark was captivated by the sounds of gospel music he heard on the Singing Jubilee and Rex Humbard's Cathedral of Tomorrow. But after experiencing a personal family heartbreak as a teenager, Mark slipped into a dark depression until this music he loved as a child became the only medicine that could draw him back. A 15-year-old boy boarded a bus to Memphis, and gospel music not only became his life, it saved his life. In 1980, Mark joined the legendary Cathedral Quartet, and for 10 and a half years, he mastered his craft, learning from the masters. Mark would go on to play a significant role in groups like Greater Vision and Gold City. In 1993, he was licensed as a Baptist evangelist. Now with his bride, Larissa, of 40 years, his beautiful family, and son, Nick, by his side, Mark leads one of the top quartets in the business and is a mentor to young singers, encouraging them to conceive, believe, and achieve. Congratulations, Mark Trammell. George and Glenn must be so proud.
And now here to speak on the behalf of Mark are two of his closest friends and buddies and children. How about it for Nick Trammell and the inimitable Gerald Wolf? How about it, huh? I asked Gerald the other day, I said, how do you feel about this? And I heard that a pastor asked him, Gerald Wolf, he said, Gerald, do you sing for money? Gerald said, no, but a check sure relieves the stress. I'll say,
your turn, Gerald.
No, come over here, Nate.
There we go. Sorry, I'm having to help my mom up here. I was honored when they asked if I wanted to speak for this. I don't do much public speaking. So they asked if my mother wanted to speak. And I said I would ask her. And she said if I got up there, I'd probably just cry through everything. I wouldn't be able to talk much. So she said, I'll just come stand next to you. So here she is. See, the backbone behind what my dad's been able to do for the last 40 years, this is it right here. I'm proud of you. Nobody that does what we do can be successful in it without having the support at home. And I just want to say thank you to my mom for 40 years of doing that, and thank you to my wife of 10 years this year for being that support for our group. And to the wives of every group member here, you keep us going, and we appreciate that. It was easy to grow up. Hey, buddy. This is Charlie. He wanted to wear his singing suit today. They get along well, I promise. It was easy growing up watching my dad and wanting to be him. He sang with the best groups. He won all of the awards, sang on some of the biggest stages, and people still to this day, they come up to the table and they quote George Yonts when they say, your dad was the perfect quartet man. And a lot of people come up and say that, and I don't think they quite exactly know what that means. They just quote what George said. So I gave a definition to it, and I want to read that for you as my portion of the speech today. The perfect quartet man. He knows his part and he sings it on pitch. Knows everyone else's part and can sing it better than they can. Can be a bus mechanic if needed. Can drive a bus smooth enough that the rest of his group can sleep through the night. And can sing a whole program after he's been up all night driving the bus. He can be producer, singer, and engineer in the studio. And he's done all three very well. can set up and tear down an entire sound system by himself, and he can EQ the sound system by ear. He can pick songs that have a message, that have something to say, and he can give them to the right people in the group to sing those messages. Perfect Quartet Man dedicates his life to perfecting his craft and to making the others around him want to be better. And he trusts God with everything in his life. And on top of all that, he still manages to put his family first. So, Dad, on behalf of your family standing here today, we love you and we're proud of you.
Says on the paper 2 to 3 minutes after my name, and it is impossible to condense more than 40 years into 2 to 3 minutes. And Nick obviously found the notes I had written down, and I don't need any notes. I did hear George say many times on the bus, there is no better quartet man that I've ever worked with than Mark Trammell. And I do believe what Nick said, that one of the reasons he's been able to be that quartet man is because he had the ultimate quartet wife. I think someday there will be some spouses of gospel singers, husbands and wives, that nobody knows, that you will see in heaven, that will have to carry their crowns in a wheelbarrow for all the stuff they had to endure so their spouses could do what they do. I believe that. Mark's the ultimate quartet man, and he and I have become like brothers over the last 37 years in every way you can imagine. We love like brothers love. We fight like brothers fight. We have those great days and those bad days. But if there's one thing I can be certain of, it is that Mark Trammell's going to be the most consistent, unwavering person you will ever encounter. He never changes. He demands perfection in what he does and in what everybody around him does as well. And I think if there has ever been anyone who you could say should be in the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame, if there's ever a picture dictionary, Mark Trammell's picture will be there, because I've never in my life known anyone who loved the music, loved the people, and loved his Lord any more than my brother, Mark Trammell. Thank you, Mark.
You've helped me for 40 years. You can help me do this too. I dare not have a sermon outline for this time in my life. And I don't have a sermon outline, but I did make notes because today is one of those days in life that will only come one time. And I have been privileged down through the years to be the recipient of your grace and your love in many different ways. But today, as I was seated waiting for this time to come, I looked on my phone at the definition of overwhelmed. And when you get home, look it up. and you'll find out truly how I feel today. I would like to say thank you to the following: to my friend Arthur Rice and all the members of the SGMA for this truly overwhelming honor. To my Lord, and my master, for giving me the talent and the desire to be a gospel singer in the good times as well as the bad, for turning a dream into a life's call, for saving my soul from hell, and for faithfully providing for my family and I when the world said it's impossible. To my wife, Larissa, my son, Nick, my daughter-in-law, Jessica, my grandchildren, Tessa and Charlie. They are just as called to this as I am. They have to be in order for me to be what you define as successful. And they are. They are truly the earthly foundation of the work that God has set in front of me to do. To my dad and to my mom, for sacrificing Christmas 1972 to buy my first bass guitar. It was $149 that I know they didn't have, and they decided they didn't need Christmas that year. To Ray Shelton for giving me my first job as a professional gospel singer. To Jim Hefner, Eldridge Fox, Glenn Payne, George Yance, Gerald Wolfe, and Tim Riley for believing in me and allowing me to live my dream through their ministries. To the men on my bus, you are the best quartet I've ever traveled with. To every man I have ever ridden a bus with, you know who you are. And God used you to help make me who I am today. I'm reminded of the turtle on the fence post. You guys helped me get here. This was not a solo venture. To the gospel songwriter, without you, I wouldn't have a song to sing. So I'm grateful for you, all of you. To my best friends, and you know who you are, those in this room, thank you for just being there. To my gospel music family, your support has fed me, paid my bills since August 17, 1974. I have never taken that for granted. I truly love what I do. Am I perfect? No. And if you don't believe me, you can ask the lady standing to my left. And last, I say this. I am grateful for this recognition of God's work in my life. And that's what I see it as. Someone asked me, how does it feel to know that your face is going to be on a plaque in the Gospel Music Hall of Fame? And without even thinking, I said, I've been around those old people all of my life. It's just going to be natural for me. God bless you. We love you.
Love for Mark Trammell and his family as they leave the stage today. They're getting ready to sing. Don't go away. We got work for you to do, Mark. Wow. The boys are going to join him and they're going to sing. You know, Mark mentioned that he didn't have his sermon outline. You would know from that, and many of you already know, that he is a Baptist minister. Isn't that right? And I'm a Baptist minister, and many of you are. but don't let it get you too high and lifted up, you know. Reminded me of the two ladies that were walking up the street, and this frog jumped up on the side of the curb and said, if one of you ladies will kiss me, I'll turn into a Baptist preacher. So this girl just reached down and picked up the frog and put it in her pocket. The other girl said, well, aren't you going to kiss it and see if it works? Oh, no, she said, Baptist preachers are a dime a dozen, but a talking frog's hard to find. Here they are, the Mark Trammell Quartet. Give them love. Let them know you're there.
Praise the Lord. Too many miles behind me. Too many trials are through. Too many tears. Why, they help me remember there's just too much to gain, to lose. I've crossed the hot burning desert, struggling the right road to choose. Somewhere up ahead, there is cool, clear water, and defeat is one word I just won't use.
Too many sunsets lie behind the mountain.
Trammell Quartet, too much to gain to lose. Boy, that statement is so true. How many